I don't think anybody goes to Haiti to make money or to destroy or to prevent anything. I think it's all starts with a good heart, you know? But good heart is not enough. You do make mistake. And of course, when you are, let's say, a very young and idealist person and you go to a, you know, poor country like Haiti, you want to do good, and then after 6 months, you are fighting with your own superiors. Because your own superiors, at the end of the year, they have to do their report, the numbers have to be correct, and they have to make sure that the next year they will have money, even more money. You know, each time I would go into a circle, let's say one particular NGO, or the government, or the prime minister, or the UN, if I stay long enough, everything seems logical. You know, if you start understanding, you start understanding their constraints, their problem, their, you know, the fighting with the boss, the fighting with the country, where the money comes from, and that the parliament have to vote for that money, and we cannot spend it in that corner, but we can. So all these problems, you know, you start to wonder, yeah, they are right. But then when I go in another place and then I start adding up all those things, that's when you realize something is wrong, it's not functioning.
Je ne peux pas vraiment dire que les choses pourraient être mieux sans la communauté internationale. Mais je dirais que la manière dont la communauté internationale a procédé est très mauvaise. C'est-à-dire la communauté internationale, pour moi, n'a pas pris contact avec les différents acteurs du pays. Je voudrais dire les élus, je voudrais dire la société civile, je voudrais dire la classe politique et même la presse. Si on rentre comme ça dans un pays, on commence à travailler, il est normal que les résultats soient mauvais.
Yeah, I can't really say that things would have been better and that we would have been able to help ourselves better without the international community. But I think that the manner that they have tried to help us was not right, because they never took any contact with the forces in the country, with the main actors in our country, be it the civil society or political actors or even the press.
I think Haiti is an extreme example, but what happened in Haiti isn't that different than what's happened elsewhere. Even in fairly wealthy countries like Raoul was mentioning Katrina or the Sandy reconstruction, some of that has to do with an impulse that we have to take advantage of a disaster to do long-range strategic projects that have been on the drawing boards for a long time, rather than really focus specifically on the households and the needs of the households and how to get people back to their sort of social and economic life.
But does it actually mean, last question, other people who saw the film immediately said, oh my God, now he's going to get applause from the wrong side. Nobody is going to give money anymore. Nobody is going to give anymore. Is that a good result? Because the money won't be spent
frankly,
well anyway?
From a Haitian point of view, it doesn't matter for us. Besides, again, as Nader put it, yes, of course, when you are in an emergency, people do need food, do need shelter, do need medicine. But that doesn't have to be more than a month or two or three. Then you come into something else. And this something else is destroying the country. I know families do need, you know, to provide. But at the same time, when it doesn't, it's not a real answer. They just lose time waiting for something that will never come. Whereas if, you know, if they don't have any help, that's not what I'm saying, they shouldn't be helped, but they will manage like Haitians have been managing, trying to survive every day. More than half of humanity is living in cities. That means every little incident will produce a catastrophe. So there will be, it's the same pattern again and again, whether it's a poor country or a rich country. So your involvement is as well. Wish, and I hope that this film will help. Thank you.